For the Bernard Perry family from Wales, the benefits outweighed the cost when it came time to see the new Pope.
Well, we spent over €1,000 just spending money. Hotel bills, that's another €1,500. And then flights, another €800. So it's been a costly tour, but it's worth it.
Tourism experts estimate that about a tenth of the 46 million people who travel to Italy each year are not primarily headed for the Spanish Steps or the Colosseum, but for that tiny country entirely encircled by the city of Rome, the Vatican. Religious tourists like the Perrys, and when the man at the top changes, those involved in the tourism business here know it's going to be a good year. At the Intercontinental Hotel de la Ville, home to several of the 130 official delegations and scores of tourists during the papal inauguration, the event was a one-time windfall. But the manager says a new pope could improve business for some time to come.
Definitely, we will expect, at least for the next 2 years, to register an increase in Latin American markets.
It's difficult to get an exact figure on what the impact of a new pope might be on the Italian economy, but tourism here represents about 10% of the gross domestic product. And tourism officials say that during the month of March, when the new pope was elected and took office, the number of visitors to Rome was up by about 4 or 5%. Easter weekend alone, hotel rooms in Rome were close to sold out.
Now at Easter, we have the peak, of course, for the Easter. We touched the 6% more than the last year.
It's hard to say precisely how many people are religious tourists, but seeing the Argentinian Pope in the Vatican is expected to be of high interest throughout Latin America.
Everybody wants to be here. Like, if I want to be here, like, everybody does.
So while some in Italy are facing economic despair, around the Vatican, there is hope, not only spiritually, but economically as well. Jim Bitterman, CNN, Rome.